Well, whatever way you look at it, the ALP has a serious political hangover at the moment. Hangovers, it has to be said, for many other Australians, unfortunately, is almost part of their daily way of life. 800,000 people in this country are alcohol dependent, and that sort of drinking can be very destructive, not just to drinkers, but also to their families and their loved ones. That said, there is actually a drug available that can stop people drinking. It's been around for more than 60 years with quite stunning success, so you'd think it'd be widely prescribed, but it isn't, and no one seems to know why. Here's Max Futcher.
These days, Hugh Murphy enjoys a life of clarity, much different from when he'd drink two bottles of rum a day. The 50-year-old business analyst is blunt when he talks about where alcohol was taking him.
I would drink and then it would escalate until I was sort of drinking 24 hours a day. Basically, I wouldn't be here if I hadn't decided to do something about it.
He made that life-changing decision after being rushed to hospital in an ambulance. After several false starts, he discovered a pill that made all the difference.
Probably saved my life. Once I took the drug and there was no choice, I stopped thinking about alcohol. It was just get on with your life without alcohol. It made that decision for you.
The drug is Antabuse, the commercial name for desulfiram. Once taken, the user can't drink alcohol without becoming seriously ill.
Not enough people know that there are now medical alternatives for the treatment of alcohol dependence.
There are three main drugs sometimes used in combination. The others are naltrexone and Campril, which decrease the craving to drink on a subconscious level. And then there's Antabuse.
And so that has the capacity to cut through the craving cycle. And so when somebody starts to think, oh, I could have a drink, they can be reminded in their own head, I've taken one of those pills, it'll be a really bad experience if I drink. And if they decide, I'll have a little try, very quickly they become sick with it.
Most recently, the drug got attention when footballer Brendan Favola revealed he was using it.
And I said, put me on it, because I don't want to drink anymore.
The fact that there's a lot of young football players are in trouble isn't a surprise. They're young Australian males. Young Australian males, a lot of them drink too much, and some of them get caught.
Antabuse is not new. It's been around for 60 years. In the US, judges in Indiana even use the drug in sentencing for repeat drink drivers.
Many doctors believe the drug should be more widely prescribed in Australia, but like the disease it's trying to treat, people don't want to talk about it. Many alcoholics don't even want to try it. That's why loved ones need to know that it is an option, but it's not a silver bullet.
These medicines are useful, but they're not the only thing that can do, that you can do to help people. And so certainly getting counselling, having family interventions, going to Alcoholics Anonymous.
Its success depends on the user's dedication to treatment. There must be a conscious decision to kick the habit. One downside is having to avoid alcohol, even in small doses, in certain foods.
You have to be a little careful with desserts and punch bowls and that sort of thing.
For Hugh Murphy, it's a small price and one that's been well worth it.
Fascinating and important. Max Futcher there. Police tell us that the vast majority of their call-outs are alcohol-related. Domestic violence, drink driving, brawling and sexual assaults, to name a few. Sadly, no magic pill will cure all that.